After many CBS 2 investigations over the years, Chicago finally passed an ordinance designed to get rogue towers off city streets. That was more than a year ago.
CBS 2 investigator Dorothy Tucker thought it was time to check in on that new law to see if it's making a difference. And it didn't take her long to find companies ignoring the new rules of the road.
Hi there. Wait a minute.
I was just trying to ask a simple question.
Do you have a license from the city of Chicago to operate?
But each time.
Excuse me.
Each place.
I'm sorry?
I cannot answer anything.
Can we talk to you a second about your license?
I was met with resistance.
Can you go? Thank you.
They were all a little testy.
No, you said you're fine.
Probably because they were caught on camera, operating without a Chicago license.
Can you see it from here?
Yes.
One of them snatched Johnny Zing's car.
Is that little SUV?
The 2021 Jeep Cherokee behind the locked gates.
I feel helpless because that car has been here now 16, 17 days.
Since mid-November.
There's nobody here.
We were with Zing in early December, the fourth time he'd visited Inless Towing, hoping to retrieve his car. Zing's wife was grocery shopping at Aldi's on 83rd and Cicero when she got into an accident. Moments after these photos were taken, Zing says a tow truck driver claiming he'd been sent by their insurance company was eager to help.
He's like, everything's gonna be covered. He's like, just sign here.
So he did. But the receipt only included the company's name.
He took off after I signed it and came back and gave it to me folded.
Unfolding this little yellow sheet of paper was a punch in the gut.
Labor, $895. Truck time, $895. Yard gate, $895.
And he's got one, two, three, four, $895 charges?
Five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11. 11 charges for $895.
Each.
Nearly $10,000. The insurance company negotiated the charge down to $3,000, but when the tow company wanted cash, they told Zing he was on his own.
I'm a working guy. I'm the only one that works at home. I don't have that kind of money.
Inless Towing never should have taken Zing's car. Doing so violated the Chicago ordinance. It requires companies towing damaged and disabled cars to pay a $250 license fee for every truck and storage lot. Inless ignored this. It's been more than a year since the law passed.
Hello?
Which is why the CBS 2 investigators.
Do you have a license from the city of Chicago?
Are asking questions.
I'm from Channel 2 News.
Trying to determine if the mission.
Are you, yeah, can we talk to you a second about your license?
To protect the public from rogue tours.
You should have an emblem.
Is working.
Inside here that says from the city somewhere. I don't see it.
Based on street surveys, documents, and data, here's what we discovered. Nearly 600 tow companies are registered with the state, but only a fraction, just 27, are licensed to operate in the city of Chicago. The difference represents a frightening number of unlicensed towers, and some could be taking advantage of unsuspecting drivers. Here's what else we found. One of the licensed towers was slapped with an F rating by the Better Business Bureau, Priority Record Service.
You know, I was frustrated because
Sandra Crump was among the many complaining to the BBB. She made the mistake of calling Priority last July when her car broke down right here in the loop.
Because it was probably the cheapest one that I called.
All she needed was a jump. The quote over the phone, $100. The bill at the scene, $300.
I mean, you could be angry, but I was just shocked. I was like, wait a second.
Here's the kicker. Priority had the F rating long before Chicago gave them a license. And that's not all. The CBS 2 investigators discovered the tow company also had more than a dozen state violations and at one point had his state license revoked. But none of that seemed to matter.
Why would you give a license to a tow company that has such a horrible state record?
Alderman Gilbert Villegas sponsored the ordinance.
I may have to defer that to BACP because maybe I'm not sure what the application reads.
BACP, that's the city department that oversees licensing. He
Here's the ordinance. It basically says a tow company can't get a license if the owner has been arrested, convicted, or on parole in the last 5 years.
But nothing in this six-page document prevents a tow company with a history of state complaints and citations from roaming the streets of Chicago and preying on innocent drivers.
And if it's not on the application, then we need to put that on there so that way we can make sure that we are not licensing bad actors.
The city does try to catch bad actors.
They got one on the box, 4700 South Cicero.
A team of local and state investigators accompanied by Chicago police.
Vehicle accident with injuries.
Patrol the streets.
Yeah.
On the day we tagged along, they snagged.
These are all potential victims.
All tows matter.
So this potential victim was approached by this tow truck driver.
Nobody called them. They just showed up. That's against the law.
She was given both these cards for potentially steal her vehicle and take it to their tow yard and hold it for ransom. He would have tried to steal your car just now.
The driver was saved. The tow company cited.
He's going to have several tickets.
Plus a big black mark.
And he's also going to get a cease and desist order to not operate.
Not operate. Meaning, if the driver of the company is called one more time.
Actually, any agent of the company operates that vehicle is subject to arrest.
In that case, this company should have been off the streets a long time ago. The CBS 2 investigators discovered All Toes Matter has been slapped with not one, two, or three, but five cease and desist orders between April and July of this year. This is number six.
What's the use of issuing these cease and desist orders when they're ignoring them? What else can you do?
Yeah, we're going to have to take a look at that because that's unexcusable. So we're going to have to work at the local level, at the state level, in order to figure ways that we can punish these folks.
Something else inexcusable?
Nobody's in here. There's a lock right there. There's a light on.
The way Johnny Zing is being treated by Endless Towing. Remember, he's just trying to get his car back. At one point, there was hope. The owner of the lot showed up and opened the gate.
So we can come in?
We all went in and found the car.
This is where they hit my wife and they bent that tire in.
But minutes later, bad news came barreling in. After some convincing, the tow driver allowed Zing to remove his son's car seat. But he wouldn't budge on returning the car.
Come on.
Without the cash.
One more thing. Endless Towing also has a history of state violations. In fact, the company has been fined $3,500 for misleading the public about tow charges. Dorothy Tucker, CBS 2 investigators.
Well, the Zings did finally get their car back after their insurer paid $4,500.
We've learned Endless Towing also faces a deadline next week to pay those fines or have its state registration revoked.